Corneonic villi. What is corneonic villi? Corneo villi is the projection present within the outer cell mass. This is the second week of development. You know the second week of the development, the outer cell mass is converted into cytotrophoblast and syncytotrophoblast. You see there is a projections of the cell present within the cytotrophoblast, and it is covered by the syncytotrophoblast. You see this projection is more developed in this region, but it is less developed in this region. So this region in future develop placenta. So this projection is known as the primary corneonic villi. Corneonic villi are three types: primary, secondary and tertiary. This classification based on the structure. So primary corneonic villi is formed by the cytotrophoblast covered by syncytotrophoblast. If we cut like cut cross sections of primary corneonic villi, so in the center we found cytotrophoblast, and around the cytotrophoblast we found syncytotrophoblast. So this is the structure of primary corneonic villi. You know there is the extra embryonic mesoderm present. These are the extra embryonic mesoderm. It has two layer. This is somatoporic layer, this is planctoporic layer of extra embryonic mesoderm, and these two extra embryonic mesoderm connected here by connecting stalk. So this is the location of future placenta. So thus now the primary corneonic villi structure of the primary corneonic villi is changed. You see the somatoporic layer of extra embryonic mesoderm is projected within the cytotrophoblast. So if we cut here at the center, we found somatoporic layer of extra embryonic mesoderm, then cytotrophoblast, then syncytotrophoblast. So this is the structure of secondary corneonic villi. So here you see this is the somatoporic layer of extra embryonic mesoderm. Within this somatoporic layer of extra embryonic mesoderm, blood vessel is start to form. This is the fetal blood vessel. So now this projection is known as the tertiary corneonic villi. So what is the difference between secondary corneonic villi and tertiary corneonic villi? In secondary corneonic villi, extra embryonic somatoporic layer, cytotrophoblast and syncytotrophoblast. But here the fetal blood vessel present within the somatoporic layer of extra embryonic mesoderm, then cytotrophoblast, then syncytotrophoblast. So this is the structure of tertiary corneonic villi. So summary of primary corneonic villi: if we cross section of this primary villi like this, we cross section, so this structure of the primary corneonic villi: center cytotrophoblast surrounded by syncytotrophoblast, here center somatoporic extra embryonic mesoderm, cytotrophoblast, syncytotrophoblast, and here the tertiary corneonic villi, the fetal blood vessel present within the somatoporic layer of extra embryonic mesoderm, cytotrophoblast and syncytotrophoblast. You see here the cytotrophoblast layer is discontinuous. So the fetal blood vessel is only separated from or close contact with the syncytotrophoblast. In this picture you see this is the lacunae present within the syncytotrophoblast, and this is maternal blood. So this is fetal blood. If the cytotrophoblast layer is discontinuous, then the barrier between maternal blood and fetal blood is only the syncytotrophoblast. So the nutrition and gas easily exchanged between maternal bud and fetal bud. So this is the main concepts of placenta. Here placenta is developed and future fetus is get nutrition from maternal blood because the fetal blood vessels and maternal blood is only separated by skin cytotrophoblast because the cytotrophoblast layer is discontinuous. Here the maternal blood vessel present, maternal blood is present within the lacunae of skin cytotrophoblast and here the fetal blood vessel. So the gaseous exchange and exchange of nutrient is only separated by skin cytotrophoblast.